back of the church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My sisters and brothers in Christ, in love and in sorrow, we have come together for this funeral mass offered for Dr. Rita Marie Resch. As our sister Rita has died with the Lord, so may she live with him in glory. In baptism, Rita received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over death. Now let's begin with her opening hymn.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly dwelling, the tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. We are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Rita's loved ones, our faith community here at St. Agnes, may I offer a sincere and heartfelt welcome to all of you who have come to remember and pray for her at this Mass, and also those who could not be here or maybe watching it on the video that's been prepared. I would like to offer my deepest sympathy to those who shared in Rita's life, her godson, Mark Zeltinger, her cousins, Joanne, Resch, Martin and Evelyn Rubens, Evan and Deb Zeltinger, Carl and Roy Zeltinger, Priscilla and Stuart Robertson, and her many, many other cousins, along with her dear and caring friends, especially Miss Wendy Stallings and Dr. Robert Lawrence, and to those who cared for her in special ways. For all who love Rita, the past few days have likely brought much reflection and emotion. To lose the presence of someone who means so much to us naturally invites us to think about the impact of that person's presence and the moments that were shared. Some memories come right away, and others take more time to surface. Amidst her many degrees and accomplishments, as noted in her obituary, noted that she was a member and associate organist, a professional title, associate organist of Saints Peter and Paul and Polly here in St. Agnes and St. Sacred Heart Catholic Church in Lawrenceburg, Missouri. Her musical, her vocal talents were shared with us here at St. Agnes. Now I've heard from a number of people of their appreciation for her doing that, coming back many different times and just filling in or taking the place of the organist. She loved to give to others, not only through her music and her voice, but also through the angel tree when she would shop for others, especially children. She opened her home to a friend who was struggling financially, just to name a few of the many others. It was said that she was generous to a fault, contributed to whoever reached out to her. Reminded me of a quote from St. Teresa of Calcutta. She said, "I am a little pencil in the hand of a writing God who is sending a love letter to the world." So we see how many ways that our Lord must have worked through Rita to bring his love to others in so many different ways, whether it be her music, or how much she gave to others, her great love for others. In our gospel passage from John today, Jesus says, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life, and will not come to condemnation, but is passed from death to life." When Jesus first spoke those words, those who he spoke to probably didn't know what he meant. What could it mean to pass from death to life? What did he mean by eternal life? They had not seen Jesus' resurrection yet. We also do not know the full extent of what this means. But the truth of the Paschal mystery has passed on to each one of us. Jesus, in his abundant love for Rita and for us, sacrificed his life and he's conquered death. The sacred mystery is really a source of infinite hope. As Christians, we believe that death never has a final word. Our first reading from the Book of Wisdom also presents us with this great hope. "For those, Rita included, who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him, with God in love. Because grace and mercy are with God's holy ones, and his cares with his elect." And Paul, as we heard in our second reading, describes life as a tent that we live in. Some get to live in that tent here on earth longer than others. But if somebody lives in a tent, it's because they're traveling and intend to move from place to place, because a tent's only a temporary dwelling. It really was a good description by Paul for the fact there were only pilgrims in this world. Only pilgrims in this world on a journey to God. And our challenge as travelers or pilgrims is to keep our sight always fixed, not just on the appearance of this life, but on the fact that we were created by God and for him, that we cannot be truly happy unless we live as God wishes us to live, keep our eyes fixed on the fact that our destiny is eternal life. Our lives are truly precious. They are mysterious. We too, as Rita already has, will understand that mystery more clearly when we come to Him face to face in our passing from this life. Having a great faith does not remove the sorrow of death, but gives us the assurance and firmness when we will soon pray, "Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended." You know, why do we have funerals? It's a good question. First of all, we need to remember and pray for the person who has passed on, whom we are offering this Mass for. But we must also allow this experience to have an impact on our own lives. We don't like to think about death, but we must remember that every one of us will someday come to the end of our earthly journey, and to have that sense of the need to be prepared at that time. Rita herself, I believe, was to receive the sacraments of the Church as she prepared, as she continued that journey to life with our Lord. Today, this Holy Mass is being offered for Rita and for her family and friends. It's truly the meal of Christ's presence, where we receive the bread of life. May the words of Holy Scripture and the Eucharist strengthen us with food for our journey, giving us peace, love, hope, and consolation in times of challenge. Rita, you are now free from the sufferings of this life. You have now gone to meet the Lord, continuing that journey that was nourished here with the Eucharist and other sacraments that you have received. Eternal rest grant unto Rita, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. May her soul, the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. With deep sorrow and the loss of the one we love, we now call on God, source of all kindness and comfort.
For Rita, through baptism, was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our sister Rita, who at the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the Church, that she may be a comforting witness to Christ, our resurrection, and our life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the family and friends of our sister Rita, those here present, and those unable to be with us this day, that the Lord may heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief and mourning. May the Lord give them peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the departed members of Rita's family who preceded her in death, especially her parents, Clement and Magdalena Resch, may they enjoy unending light and peace in the kingdom of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the whole Church, that we prepare worthily for the hour of our death, when God calls us each by name to pass from this world to the next. personal needs that we now lift up to God in the silence of our hearts. That our Lord will give us help in our every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, we affirm our faith and our hope in the resurrection of your Son. Comforted by your grace and your promise of eternal life, we offer you our prayers this day through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice of yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Rita, we beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with you,
sir. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. Hence all angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Church on earth, with your
your servant Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Rita, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform her lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you are God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
at this point in time, the funeral liturgy, I just invite all those who are Catholic, who are practicing their faith and spiritually prepared today to receive, come up to receive communion. But otherwise, those who may not be Catholic or not spiritually prepared, you also can come up to receive a blessing just to cover your chest like this and give you a blessing.
I am the bread of life.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant strength and body it, our sister Rita may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Rita, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Rita again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the peace of Christ. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever.
We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just invite all of you to the fellowship downstairs following the funeral today. Bars and such coffee has been prepared for fellowship and continue to share memories of Rita. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise, and the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new Rita.